जयदलितं वाघवोत्थं महान्तं जित्वा रात्रिं प्रकृतिसहजं अन्धता मिश्रमिश्रम्
Shri Ramakrishna was the embodiment of cumulative effects of spiritual and cultural life of modern India, generated and preserved through the ages by saints and sages. He drew pointed attention to the real spirit of Indian civilization. This is Kumarpukur, 30 miles northwest of Calcutta, where Ramakrishna was born in 1836. Kumarpukur presents a peaceful and pastoral look of a medieval village. Humble ancestral cottages of Ramakrishna, the Haldar tank, the house of a Shudra woman who happened to be the godmother of Ramakrishna, a small school run by the Laha Zimidars. All these spots reviving holy memory still stand there in nature's beauty. In one of the ancestral cottages, the deity of Raghuveer was installed by his father, Khudiram Chattopadhyay. This is the Shiva temple where the advent of Ramakrishna was prognosticated. Mother Chandramani, while worshipping there, found the divine image quickened into life. A ray of light penetrated into her depths and she fell unconscious. When she came to, an idea flashed that the divine soul would be born as her son. The blessed moment arrived, and on the 18th of February 1836, child Ramakrishna was born before daybreak. Time rolled on and saw the simple child grow into adolescence, almost unnoticed, and then pass through extraordinary spiritual practices for 12 years. At last, a prophet of universal religion emerged to the modern world, proclaiming divinity in man. As many faiths, so many paths, and the harmony of all religions. The 11th of May 1951 saw the installation of a statue of Ramakrishna and his holy relics in a temple built and consecrated in his sacred memory. Here are some of the scenes from the ceremonies performed in this connection. Near the temple under the mango tree, once planted by the saint himself, the Yajna Mandap was erected for ceremonies performed on the previous day. Pandits from holy Banaras came to do the performance for 3 days from dawn to sunset. Sadhus and devotees gathered to witness the function. Over to Jairam Bhatti, the village home of Holy Mother Shardamani. This little village with cluster of cottages and sylvan surroundings presents a charming and simple rural scene. A beautiful temple consecrated in 1923 stands in her birthplace. Here a large number of devotees gather near the temple and start for Kumarpukur to participate in the celebrations. Vedic sacrifices have commenced there with the chanting of hymns. To the start of a procession from the temple with sannyasis in the front and with pictures and relics of Ramakrishna, Shardamani and Vivekananda. The activities of the Yajna Mandap go on peacefully. Everyone is busy in the Yajna Mandap. Kirtan parties are coming out with music carrying large pictures of Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother and Swami Vivekananda, and with joyous exclamations of Jai Shri Guru Maharaj Ji Ki Jai, Jai Bhagwan Shri Ramakrishna Dev Ki Jai, these echoed and re-echoed in the hearts of the devotees. Chanting of devotional hymns and prayers is proceeding in the sacrificial shed. With great devotion, the processionists are marching past. From early morning, people begin to pour into the village of Kamarpukur, some coming in buses, others in bullock carts, and the rest on foot. A joyful atmosphere pervades the whole village. In the midst of all this gaiety, the solemn functions of the sacrificial shed continues unruffled. Indefatigable volunteers are controlling with exemplary patience and courtesy the movement of the vast multitude of people. The music parties singing and dancing in ecstatic joy have infused fresh life into the celebration. Yajna continues. A mile-long procession of dancing santhals is heading its way from Jairambati to Kamarpukur with the brandish of their sticks. Here also a kirtan party is accompanied. The sacrificial fire is burning. Another party is waiting to receive the procession at a nearby canal, which was the favorite resort of Sri Ramakrishna in his childhood. Women devotees carry a beautifully decorated picture of Holy Mother singing their way to Kamarpukur. 3 miles away, barefooted and bareheaded, the two combined processions move slowly towards the temple. As the procession moves on, the crowds continue to swell. It is by his spiritual power, as it were, all these devotees were drawn together on this memorable occasion. The sacrificial ceremony is coming to a close with the chanting of the last litany.
पतये नमो नमस्यष्पिञ्जराय त्रिषीमते वधीनां पतये नमो नमो हरिगेजायोपवीतिने ृचाय व्याधिनेन्नानां पतये नमो नमो भवस्य हेत्यै जगतां पतये नमो नमो नदायिने क्षेत्राणां पतये नमो नमः सूतायाहन्यैवनानां पतये नमः नमो रोहिताय स्थपतये वृक्षाणां पतये नमो नमो भुवन्तये वारिवकृतायौषधीनां पतये नमो नमो.
Each and every devotee was anxious to reach the temple soon.
Hey, Julie!